G55 checkup. This is one of the most cleanest G55 that I have seen. It's very nice and clean. Let's start from some small things. It's not a big deal actually, but it's okay. Then we have here rear brake pads. For some people, they're gonna say that you have to change it. Nope, you don't have to change it for the simple reason because you can make another 20,000 kilometers for that. So why to change it now? Since you have another oil change between the chains. I have seen that, I have checked that car before also, and I remember how it was the brake pads, and they didn't worn out so much. Plus, you have the sensor, brake pad sensor, and there is no message inside. Oh, sorry, the brake pad sensor is here. There's the plug. Then, differential, perfect, no leak, nothing. Bushes, excellent, there is no problem at all. Shock absorbers, there is no leak. There is no any cutted spring, because I have seen many times they're going to the desert, the guys, they're jumping with the cars, and when it's tired, the spring, sometimes it's cutting, and one side is more low than the other, and it's dangerous, all right? So, it's in excellent condition. The bushes here front, excellent transfer case, not a single leak or something, very nice and clean. The mounts for the transfer case here, they are perfect, no problem, same thing also here, the other one. Then, the seal on the transfer case, they are perfect from the drive shaft, same thing for the front wheel. Then, transmission mount, it's a little bit tired, you can see it's a little bit down, but it's okay, it's G-class, there is no problem for that. Transmission oil, I don't think so, not ever change it. Because it looks like that nobody touched the bolt, and you can see also the color here around. That means nobody opened the drain plug. Then, the seals here, yeah, always have a leak on the G-Class. It's common, but it's not so much. It's not gonna do nothing, and it's driving this car in the city, so there is no problem on that. If it's gonna come worst and it's gonna be full of grease, then yes, it's strong enough. The brake discs, front brake discs, have a leak. Most probably it's out of specs, it's thinner. Then you see the brake pads. Also here front, 20%, I'll say that. There is a brake pad sensor. There is the brake pad sensor, so when it's coming the light inside, she can change the brake pads and the brake discs at the same time. I'll gonna come, but definitely with this lip, it'll gonna be out of specs. Yeah. There is a little bit uneven wear on the tires. I count it with the old classic way that you put a measurement tape, let us say from here till here, and you see the front, and then you put it from back here, this spot here, and then here, and you're counting how much it is, if let us say it's open or if it's closed, the wheels. On the eye, it looks not perfect. And since it's not okay with by eye, also if you put the machine, it's not gonna be perfect. So what does mean that one? Need wheel alignment to be okay. Don't have any problem. All the links down here are perfect. I think this is called a pitman arm in English. The steering box, there is one small leak up there, but it's not something important. I have seen worse than this. I have seen it to be fully wet here and start leaking down and working fine. So, then, what's the biggest problem? Biggest problem. We have a leak. There is a leak. Ah, by the way, this stabilizer bar, this stabilizer, let us say shock absorber that's connected on the steering here, this goes bad sometimes. And it starts shaking the steering and makes some stupid things. Anyhow, it looks like that it does have a leak. Nice and dry, the seal here. Sometimes it's not working very well. I have to open the bolt here to see, to move it by hand, to see if it's okay. So engine mounts, perfect. Yeah, since I'm here, there is no any crack or something. What's the problem now? There is an oil leak, and there is an oil leak that you can see from the belt housing here, from this spot. It's dropping down to the stabilizer bar here, and then it's dropping down to the floor. No, I don't have a leak up to now on the floor. You can see the drop there. You can say that there is a possibility, let's say, to be the leak from the seal, from the crankshaft seal, or it can be from the oil pan, or sometimes it's happening also to be from the oil pump of the transmission that has another one seal when you remove the torque converter. And there is another one case, because these engines, the M113K, there is on the valley up where is the supercharger, there is one small hole, and if you throw something there inside, if you put the water or if you put the oil or whatever, you're gonna end up back over here. It's communicating. So my question is now, is this leak from the oil pan? Because I can see it's wet here. I mean, 1 second. You can see that the oil pan here, where's the join, it's wet. From the other hand, I open this cover here and I see the flex plate inside is dry. Then I open the other cover from this side and I can see the rear seal, the crankshaft rear seal, and it looks like it's dry. And the flex plate from behind, from here, that means, and the torque converter that I can see down there inside, it also looks dry. It does look like, I mean, imagine if there was an oil leak over there, 1 second, how we're gonna do that, I don't know. If there was a leak, we're gonna start spreading all the way around the oil. It does look like to be the case. What I believe, either the oil is coming from up, from the head cover seals that's leaking, because on the passenger side it's leaking more, the driver side is less, or it's from the oil pan down here that you see that has a leak there. You see that's wet. But again, it's not that much wet, but you don't know what's happening inside. From this side, it's nice and dry. I'm talking about the join, the oil pan with the engine block here. From this side, it's nice and dry. Let's make it down to see if the covers. What's my problem now? How to solve it, this one, inexpensive, find the leak, and everybody to be happy. To don't charge the customer, let us say, to open the transmission or to open the oil pan for no reason. This is what I'm trying to do now. Anyhow, let's make it down to see from up. So this has looks like from up. From the driver's side, it's not wet, the seal. You see it's a little bit wet there front, but here where is the breather that usually they are leaking very much. It has a little bit here. It's not that much. All the rest, it looks fine. Even down there inside. Yeah, I know you can't see with the camera, but I can see that it's dry. From the passenger side now, from the passenger side, it's a different story. You have a leak from this cover, that this cover is sealing with a sealant, not with a rubber seal. And most probably, because I can see there in the middle where is the seal, I'm talking about this seal, the rubber seal, there is also a leak there. My question is, if it's leaking and it's going inside the valley down there, you're gonna tell me how you're gonna pass from the supercharger, right? No, it's dry over there. Yeah, it's dry. You can see that it has some leak down there. Always with one M113K, with the M113K, always the same story. Because to locate exactly from where is the leak, okay, you can see that it's from the covers. How much are leaking? If it's leaking from there, from the seals. Looks like it's not leaking so much. It may wet, yes, obviously. You're gonna be good at this if you remove the supercharger, but why to spend all this time and remove the supercharger? And since it came for oil change, engine oil filter, on the G-Class you have plenty of space to open the oil pan. And to seal the oil pan, no need to buy a gasket or seals or something. They are applying sealant, even from the factory, as you saw before, earlier. So that's my plan now. What I'm gonna do for now. We're gonna drain the oil, we're gonna move the oil filter, we're gonna open the oil pan down, and then we're gonna see if it's the leak from there. At least we're gonna know before we start making the covers and this kind of stuff. It's the most easier and most inexpensive, and since it's wet from one side and there is a leak down there, when I'm gonna open it, I'm gonna know for sure if it's coming from the oil pan or if it's coming from up. It's gonna be much more clear the view for me. So yeah, that's the status. This is just only to inform the owner how it's the situation. The, as I said, the car is very clean, it's very nice, perfect square lines. Yeah, well, this is okay. This is happening. Even to the best drivers, they're happening. This one. It's plastic, it's not even metallic. It's not a big deal. All the rest is excellent. So, engine oil, oil filter, wheel alignment, and removing the oil pan, clean the surfaces, see from where is the leak, seal it by again, and get the feedback from the customer. That's the plan. What else? Ah, I need to fix also on the inside of the glove box, the one plug that went away. All right, and there is one thing with the indicator light. Sometimes it's showing that it's burnt, but it's not burnt. So I can open the glass and see if the contacts inside, where it's stepping the bulb, if they are clean. Maybe need to clean it a little bit and put back inside. All right, not bad. That's it. That's one small video. Maybe if I open the oil pan, maybe we're gonna start again the camera to see how it looks like. Thank you very much. Because I don't remember what I said about the Z-glass on the camera. Let's repeat 1 minute what I said. There is an oil leak, and it's continuously the oil leak. You can see that it's coming wet. So either it can be from the covers, ceiling head covers, but again, you're not gonna have so much leak, or it can be from the crankshaft rear seal, that it's not wet, also the flex plate is not wet, and you can see signs on the oil pan, around the oil pan from the passenger side down, that's wet, especially back. So, me, what I'm saying, since we're gonna make an oil change, and since no need to purchase any parts for the oil pan down, it's just need to be open it, clean the surfaces. Before you clean the surface, I want to see if there is a real leak from there. Clean the surfaces, seal it again, put back again up, finish the story. Everybody happy. So the most inexpensive and the proper way for me, for my head, how to approach this leak is we're draining the oil because we have to change the oil. Alright? We remove the oil pan. I see, let us say, from where is the leak, if there is any problem there. And then we seal it and put by again. Inexpensive, need to be done because it's already wet from one side. And if you do it, let us say, if I change the oil and leave it for 1 month later or 2 months later, then you have to remove the oil, keep the oil somewhere, then put the bike again inside. At the same time, I can see also on the pickup tube if there is, let us say, the O-ring, if it goes apart, then we change one O-ring. It's a good chance. And, okay, it's not a new car, obviously. It's almost 10 years old. So, the rubbers and all these things are burning. That's why I said, since we have to make an oil change, it's a good chance, just only open the oil pan down and reseal it. And this I'm making again, because I don't remember what I said before. I don't remember if I saw him also only the leak, or if I mentioned why I want to go there. I mean, in one case, you have to open the covers, you have to degrease the covers, you have to sand the sides, 4 hours job. In the other case, to remove the transmission, you have to remove the transmission, throw it down, remove the flex plate, and then see inside the rear crankshaft seal that it looks dry. In the other case, you have to just only unbolt the bolts on the oil pan, drop it down, you have it on your hand. It does have a cross member, it's G-class, has plenty of space down there, so you don't have to support, let us say, the engine with the bridge and remove the cross member to be able to open the oil pan. You have it there in front of you. That's why I said what I said. Thank you very much. Let's continue here.